The authorities of AFVM Sri Pushpam Autonomous College, Pundi, Tanjavur, the secretary and correspondent, principal, dean, COE, HOD, and organizing committee of international virtual conference on the spirit of humanism in English literature. The special invited guest, panelists and speakers who have talked earlier to me, and those who are present here with me on this virtual dais, Professor Dr. R.S. Bhaskaran from Omar Al Mukhtar University, Al Guba, Libya, particularly Dr. R. Shanti and my friend Dr. K. Sivakumar, who have insisted me to accept this invitation, and this esteemed online participant, attendee, faculties and students. A very good afternoon to one and all. The core topic of this virtual conference is the spirit of humanism in English literature. And the subtopic allocated to me is literature in the time of crisis, trauma, and vulnerabilities. Friends, humanism is a way of thinking about the world. It is a set of ethics or ideas about how people should live and act. People who hold this set of ethics are called humanists. Humanists prefer critical and rational thinking over acceptance of dogma or superstitions, and stresses the importance of human values and dignity. It focuses on helping people and make the world a better place. It is a movement that traces the wisdom of the classics, human dignity and potential. Humanistic therapy is used to treat depression, anxiety, panic disorders, personality disorders, and different types of crises and traumas. It is a philosophy of joyous service for the goodness of all humanity. The roots of humanist philosophy lie in the early 14th century Italian scholar Petrarch, who is often called as one of the first humanists. Petrarch rejected traditional medieval scholarship in favor of a revival of classical authors like Aristotle, Plato, and so on. Petrarch's ideas were developed further during the Renaissance by scholars, writers, and civic leaders in the 14th and early 15th century. Humanism at the beginning was only a literary movement, but soon also spread to everyday living, table manners, and outfits. Humanism can be seen clearly in different writing pieces, different written pieces, different paintings, and different sculptures. For example, as far as literary piece is concerned, Hamlet by William Shakespeare includes introspection, self-awareness, and musing about mankind. Mark Twain's The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn shows humanism when Huck treated the slave Jim as a human being and recognizes his worth. Niccolo Machiavelli, who painted The Prince, addresses the idea that people should be responsible for their actions. They have a role in their own destiny and they should not blame God or pet for everything. In the 20th century, the label literary humanism was used in more narrow sense to describe a movement in the humanities which focused almost exclusively on literary culture. This is to say, the ways in which literature can help people through introspection and personal development. As we emerge into 21st century, for the first time in history, mankind has been brought together by worldwide global platforms. Issues like international security, the population explosion, and the needs of the third world countries have recently begun to be addressed. The international climate of humanism has been most recently demonstrated by the global response to the Ebola epidemic in Western Africa, and today the same is being witnessed regarding COVID-19 pandemic. Epidemics and pandemics are humanitarian crises, and hence they are the subjects of biomedical branch or biologists and medical experts, as well as of literature. The pandemic crisis not only points to the need for humanism, but in another sense, it has brought the world together, demonstrating the courage and resilience that can be achieved when we unite as one. It has inspired a sense of cohesion and connection to our shared humanity. It has provided a fertile ground for replanting the seeds of humanity care. Humanists believe that the solution to the world's problem lies in human thoughts and actions rather than divine intervention. Humanists have a duty to care to all the humanity, including future generations. Humanism commits us to an ethical way of life that looks after each other. For many of us, this has never been more apparent than in the current COVID-19 pandemic. Now, as conference topic allocated to me is concerned, let us see how literature or humanist literature or literature in general responded to such crises or the traumas and vulnerabilities. How literature helped humanity in such adversity, distress, and a crisis of society. Friends, the core subject matter of all literatures, obviously, indisputably, is a man, and its theme is human life with its infinite forms and manifestations. Humanism was a major focus of literature since ancient period, as I have already mentioned that since writings of Petrarch in 14th century. In literature, humanism is shown by complex characters struggling against the realities of fact. It is generally optimistic, though it can also show people suffering through very difficult circumstances. In the end, it is being seen that the hero of a humanistic story always wins through a combination of determination, honor, and health. Literature what I believe uplifts the soul and grants an aesthetic refinement in such lockdown or agonies of whole arrest and quarantine phase or any like crisis. Literature plays a vital role in analyzing, reviewing, and revisiting crises, traumas, and vulnerabilities, and helping us to frame our responses toward it. Over the vast history of literature, whether an Indian or Western one, different texts always offered much in dealing with crisis, a way of processing strong emotions, or in contemplating political, social, economic, or contemporary crisis of human beings. Whether it was pandemics like the plague or the Spanish flu, or epidemics like the smallpox, AIDS, swine flu, Ebola or Zika virus, or times of crisis like world wars, or some other social, global, personal crisis, literature has never taken a backseat during those times. Instead, it has always demonstrated how to get back on track. It has served as a medicine, as a vaccine. It made us aware of the invincibility of death, as well as the importance of taking precautions for recovery and safety. Literature allows us to look at such crises, traumas, and vulnerabilities via literary lenses. and how similar crises have been managed before in the past and now too. There are many texts that act as a vaccine and help us confront and overcome the crisis. Such literature provides ways of confronting such disasters. The present situation of COVID-19 is reminiscent of the scenario from the short novel, The Plague, written by Albert Camus. Camus describes the outburst of the plague in the 19th century, in which people refused to accept that pandemics has occurred, and when it turns fatal, they become miserable. The coronavirus too was ignored initially, and people continued their daily business carelessly, but it actually resulted in the widespread of the virus. Camus' novel has fresh relevance and lessons to be learned in the current coronavirus crisis. In the novel, Camus emphasized the emotional consequences of the plague. Feelings of alienation, isolation, fear, and loss and trauma. His novel projects similar to what COVID-19 is now inscribing in current civic life, our life. The exile and isolation that Camus discussed in his novel, The Plague, seems to be the same as our quarantine and lockdown phase of COVID-19, which we underwent through. That's why the World Economic Forum mentioned the Camus' Plague as one of the 5 must-read books in the light of the coronavirus crisis. Literature is compassionate toward each person and goes beyond what statistics and historical records can tell us. Such literature stands as a source of consolation, a way of sharing our common humanitarian concerns. Moral principles and ethics are taught by humanist literature. For example, it was once believed in the 17th and 19th century, and still today even too, that people's misdeeds cursed the outcome of epidemics. Isn't it the result of humans' mistreatment of environment and animals in China's Wuhan wet market, where dogs, snakes, rats, bats, and other wild animals were slaughtered and sold for food? Isn't it the result of our betrayal of nature, animals, and the environment? Such misdeeds and their consequences are often depicted in literature, which guides us. Everyone acknowledges the importance of literature in restoring broken trust and restoring fundamental values in life during the disaster stage. Literary works generally have an uplifting effect on people. They are therapeutic. Aristotle emphasized that tragedy is cathartic hundreds of years ago. It is not just what you give, but how you give it. When work or piece of literature works at the imaginative level, there will be a meeting point between, a point of divergence, where the reader and the text meet, and they can heal or purify or console one another. Literature is the social tool for nation building and shaping the daily life in our crisis. Literature inspires and teaches people to be creative and take action in life. President George Bush cited the reading of famous book, The Great Infusa, as one of the reasons for making the future plans for his federal government to face future pandemics. The Scarlet Plague, a novel written by Jack London in 1912 that takes place during World War I, offers a fascinating reading in present circumstances of pandemic crisis. Daniel Defoe's Journal of the Plague here acts as a warning bell by serving as a realistic handbook of things to do and what not to do before and after the deadly outbreaks like present COVID-19. The Last Man, a pandemic novel by Mary Shelley, explicates the narratives of life-saving messages. In The Earth in Peril, Colin Ayer appropriately narrates pandemic culture for humanity's healing and transformation. Max Brooks' World War Z teaches how to fight the plague and maintain both the spirit of the body and mind. When the world falls apart due to the deadly disease, such narratives have the ability to preserve and restore it. In such pandemic crises, not only pandemic literature, but also other pieces of literature are worth to read to our comfort of our souls. For example, The Second Coming, a wonderful poem by W. Yeats, is famous for its prophetic message of the chaos and confusion in the modern world, turning and turning the whirling gear, etc. The falcon cannot listen, Falconer. The Second Coming is a must. He wrote the poem in the year 1990 after witnessing the Irish World War and the end of First World War, giving voice to his hopelessness for the future of humankind. The metaphor of Falcon and Falconer stands for nature and humanity. Nature no longer remains connected to the human world, and that was his exploration in that poem. While one is in crisis, one can escape to strange and unknown realms through reading the descriptions of writers. For example, from the moors of Charlotte Bronte to Coleridge's Jhandu, or Thomas Hardy's Wessex novels to R.K. Narayan's Malgudi World, we can meet people. We can interact with them. We can go through their situations, and all simply by just flipping the pages of a book. The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho, The Old Man and Sea by Ernest Hemingway, the Nobel Prize winning text, are great novels to read for inspiration and determination to tackle the problem, crises, traumas, and vulnerabilities, both personal or the social, or even the global. Studying literature when there are crises is even more imperative today. One of the major roles of literature is to provide various platforms to the readers and enables them to discover comfort, assistance, amusement, facts, encouragement, and excitement. By reading good literature, we can make our life happy, progressive, and optimistic. For example, one more example that I can give, Anthony Chekhov's story, The Bat. In this story, he portrays two characters, a banker and a lawyer. The banker says he will give the lawyers $20 million if he accepts and completes solitary imprisonment for 15 years. That is 15 years solitary confinement. It is very curious to read how the lawyer spent his time in the prison. The story is prescribed to most all universities. A very wonderful story this is. After a few years spending in doing things of his interest, the lawyer starts to read books of various kinds. Soon, he realized that he met many aspects of life by reading different kinds of the books. He has experienced and fulfilled all feelings, emotions through these stories. He has gained knowledge of many things. He got the meaning of the life. That is his achievement, and he needs money no more. He breaks the bed few hours before the last day by leaving a note of what he has gained. This teaches us lesson of importance of the reading of books or the company of the books. There is one more story entitled The Last Leap by Oventry, which is prescribed to our curricula, UG curricula, which describes the fate of John C., a poor young woman suffering from pneumonia. She lost hope in being cured from her illness. She started watching ivy vine on her building. She says that falling leaves in this vine symbolizes her sickness. She believes that she will die if the ivy lost its last leaf. His friends were very much worried of her. Met with an artist named Behrman. Behrman comes to know about the whole story, and with his creative art, paints a leaf on the wall. John C. recovers, and that last leaf remains as it is for a long time. She believes that she is recovering, and her positive energy helps her to cure. Literature gives us such types of positive energy in such types of moments of the crisis. The very famous romantic poet P.B. Shelley, in his poem Ode to West Wind, believes that if winter comes, can spring be far ahead? If winter comes, spring will inevitably follow. Reading it boosts our optimism and energy. In Frost's, Robert Frost, Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening, a 1923 poem that is written in 1923, Frost describes a traveler who travels through the night in the snow. He gets attracted toward the deep, dark silence of his surroundings, but he realizes that it is not his destination, as he has promises to keep and miles to go before. He's going to sleep and miles to go. With this confidence, we can fight with such types of pandemic or the post-pandemic life or any another time of the crisis. Humanist literature has a didactic role. These stories sometimes show how to act and sometimes show what not to do and what to do. It improves our reasoning capacities. It holds a mirror in front of society and shows us the picture for us to take decision. A single book is worth of hundreds of pens. It is a saying, very popular saying. Man cannot be alone with a book. It helps man most when he is in oppressed, pessimistic mood, when he is not able to face the world around him. It is the statistic is showing that the rate of the reading was increased in lockdown. Highest books were read in lockdown period through online or different modes. Literature plays an important role in raising public awareness of various natural disasters, and as a result, in preparing people to face any catastrophe with purpose and fact rather than emotion and outburst. Literature helps break the barriers, connecting us across different historical periods and time zones with others who have experienced similar tragedies. More importantly, literature shows us that we have a lot in common with others who are from distant lands and different times, engaging us to appreciate the fact that we are not the only ones who are dealing with the such types of devastation, what by the pandemic or such types of traumas and crises and vulnerabilities. The importance of humanism or literature in general in addressing the crisis cannot be overstated. As a result, we should be inspired and driven to combat pandemics like coronavirus or like different crises or the traumas by revisiting and rethinking different literary works. Literature has had a major influence on the evolution of humanity. It has changed political processes and transformed civilizations. Literature, you must know the role of literature in the French Revolution. You must be aware of it. That's why I use that it has changed the political processes and transformed civilizations. Literature provides us with a detailed glimpses into human experiences, enabling us to interact on fundamental levels of desire and emotions. It plays a vital role in societal change and makes significant contribution to nation building. It is one of the most significant contributors to social change. When society is confronted with a natural disaster or crisis, literature may help people to come out of it. Literature or different narratives in particular occasion empathy and provide a fresh viewpoint on one's own or others' lives. Books have the ability to uplift us, to make us see things in a new ways, and to introduce us to new ideas. I think that time allotted to me is 30 minutes, is about over. I'm summing up. That is just what we need in this trying time are books, that is literature. Reading literature during a state of emergency nurtures readers by removing loneliness, maintaining sanity, promoting resilience, instilling empathy, and most importantly, instilling the courage to hope and to face. This time will go. A single line you read will often stay with you for a long time, inspiring you to different times. It is humanism, it is literature that will tell you not to be cruel to animals, not to be wild when it comes to the environment and the nature. Otherwise, you will have to face catastrophe. You will have to face epidemics and the pandemics or the other moments of crisis, traumas, and vulnerabilities. Thanks to whole organizing team for providing me the opportunity to express myself on the given topic. Thank you. Over to the convener.
As Shakespeare said, the quality of mercy is not strength, it droppeth as the gentle rain from heaven upon the place the beneath. It is thrice blessed, it blesseth him that gives and him that takes. No doubt, the resource person, Dr. Navle, has explored the chief tenets of humanism and how it manifested itself in literature from times immemorial to the modern times, universally beyond the geographical and national boundaries. Garcia Marquez wrote, Love in the Time of Cholera, a shining and heartbreaking novel written on romantic love. And our speaker today has literally explored love in a grander scale, that is humanism, in a wider canvas, including literatures.